Hello students, my name is Prerna and today from your EVS book Enviro, we are going to be reading chapter number 4. And the good news is that all of you are going to enjoy reading this chapter a lot. Do you know why? So let's see why. What is so fun about this chapter? So here we go. This is chapter number 4, and as you can see, the name of the chapter is Fun and Games. So this chapter is about the games that you play. I'm sure all of you feel like going out right away and start playing. So you can do that, but let's just study this chapter first. There's a lot of truth in the old saying, all work and no play makes Jack a dull boy. This means that if you keep on doing something, if you keep on doing only one thing the entire day, then it will make you dull. It will make your life boring. So if you take your example of a student, if you keep on studying the entire day, if you keep on just reading also the entire day, your body will not feel refreshed. So what is it that makes our body refreshed? It is these games that we play. Most of us work very hard. Our lives would become dull and boring if we do not take a break from work. Doing something different from the routine is called recreation. Like sometimes you see, or what happens is that let's say every fortnight, that is after every 15 days or so, we go out with our family, maybe to a mall or to watch a movie. And how much fun we have during that time? You all know how much we enjoy it. So these are called as recreational activities, because they refresh you. You feel energized after doing all those activities. It makes us feel relaxed and fresh. It gives us more energy to begin the next day's routine. Types of games. So there are different games that you play. So you play Coco, you play chess. But you know, these games are divided into two categories. What are these two categories? The first category is indoor games, and as the name itself suggests, indoor games are the games that you play inside your house or probably inside a room, like chess, carom, Ludo. All these are called as indoor games. And the second category that you have is that of outdoor games. Cricket, volleyball, hockey, all these are outdoor games. So you can see these kids, they are playing indoor games, and these kids are involved into outdoor games. But these indoor games or outdoor games, they are equally important for your physical growth and your mental growth. Like you play Ludo. So how does it help in your mental development? So you know, like you get a chance to move your player. So you have to decide whether I should move this particular player or I should move that particular player. So in this process, your critical thinking, it develops. If you talk about outdoor games, let's say volleyball or hockey, you know, it strengthens your muscles a lot. So indoor games and outdoor games will always help in your growth as well as development. Now, rules of games, very, very important. All games have rules, and it is important to know the rules of the game. One way to avoid fights is to know the rules and play the game in a fair manner. That means you should never ever cheat. That's a very bad habit. Referees can be appointed to ensure that the game is played in a fair way. Who is a referee? Referee is a person who is generally chosen by a group of people who gives a decision in a game. If there is a dispute between the two teams, for example, when you are playing cricket and like, oh, this person is out, and the person says, no, I am not out. So it is the referee who takes the final decision, and we must respect the decision given by the referee. And if we are the referee, it is very important that we give a fair decision. We should not be partial towards someone. Sometimes we get into an argument with our friends while playing. This argument may cause some confusion. In such a situation, it is always better to take the help of an elder or a senior. Tell them the problem and accept their decision or advice. We can play a game in a good manner. So how can we do that? First is, you should never ever hit anyone while playing. You should never be so aggressive. First of all, you should never be aggressive at all. And even if you are, you've lost your temper, never ever hit anyone. First of all, a true sportsman will never lose his or her temper. That's what we call as the sportsman spirit. Don't push anyone. Don't kick anyone. Do not cheat. Do not abuse anyone. And always, while making strategy, discuss it with the other team players also. So every member in the team should be allowed to give their suggestion. It should not be like, oh, I am the captain, I have taken the decision and this is final. No. That means you might be a captain, but you are not at all a good captain. A good captain will always discuss with the entire team and take the right decision. Not like this, oh, okay, we have discussed, but we are going to go by the decision that I have taken. That's a sign of a bad captain. Then play at school. We play many games in school. The games that we play in our school are related to learning. And when do you play games? Either it is during your lunch break or you have a special games period. And these games also help you in your physical as well as mental development. Then play after school. After coming from school, we take rest and complete our homework. Very, very important. Once you come back from school, take some rest. And the first thing you need to do after that is to complete your homework. Don't be in a hurry to go out and play with your friends. After completing our homework, we go to play with our neighborhood friends. We play many types of games like Kho-Kho, Kabaddi, Cricket, Seven Stones, Hide and Seek, all these games. Then play with everyone. This basically is an elaboration of what you're supposed to do when you're playing with people around. So you need to play like a team, not like an individual. We must try to include our friends in the games we play. We should not stop playing with children who come from different backgrounds or speak different languages. So let's say you have a friend who doesn't speak the language that you speak. A friend who's maybe not good in a particular language. Never ever make fun of such children. In fact, encourage them to play with you. This is how you will, you'll see that you're making lifelong friends. It also helps us to develop qualities of healthy teamwork. Everyone learns to put in their best effort and give support to each other while playing. The sportsman spirit that I was talking about, to play like a team player. We should play together without differentiating between boys and girls. In earlier times, sometimes the girls were not allowed to play because they said that this is a rough game for girls, but now you see girls even entering sports like wrestling. But today, most games are played by both men and women. Now we come to the recreational activities. Like I told you, going to a mall, watching a movie. So there are some other recreational activities as well. What is this? This is a fair. Fairs or melas are organized on occasion of different festivals like Dussehra, Diwali, Christmas, and people enjoy a lot. For instance, when Sulabh and his family went in fair, they were very excited. Even I like going to the fairs a lot, and I play a lot of games when we go to the fair. Specifically those games wherein, you know, you have to throw a ring and you win something. So that's, you know, so I really enjoy playing that game. Sulabh and his family, they saw many stalls there. And his sister even ate an ice cream. They bought many toys from there. So they really enjoyed going to the fair. Then you have circus. Circus is also an exciting place to go. There are different artists who perform different tricks. So you will see animals perform playing cricket in circus. You will see a lot of acrobats. So these people, you know, they perform certain stunts and they're called as acrobats. So they you will see them hanging from a huge height and they'll be performing certain stunts in front of you. And then animals, of course, I've told you, they also entertain. For instance, Shivam and Ravina were very excited. They had never been to a circus before. They reached the circus with their parents at 7 p.m. There were colorful tents and lights. They could smell the popcorn. How were they able to smell the popcorn? Remember chapter which tells you about sensing power, chapter number 3. And they heard a band playing. Here, how do you hear? Are you able to hear? Using your ears. And they took their seats in the third and the fourth row. The ringmaster came dressed in a shiny red coat and a top hat. In his booming voice, he said, "Welcome, ladies, gentlemen, and children of all ages." So now Ravina and her brother Shivam, they got really excited. Soon the acrobats came tumbling out. They jumped and turned. They did a lot of somersaults. The jugglers tossed rings and balls in the air. Then there were two or more horses that entered the ring with riders jumping on and off their animals. The lights went off and the music changed. The spotlights went on the top of the tent as two tightrope performers balanced first on one leg and then on the other, and then with a somersault landed on the net midway. Everyone cheered for them. The clowns, they made the crowd laugh a lot. Some were on stilts while others were riding a unicycle. So what is a unicycle? It's a cycle with only one wheel. They made everyone laugh with their silly jokes and acts. So the first recreational activity that we talked about was going to a fair. The second one was going to a circus. The third recreational activity is kite flying. And this is also a popular sport in India. So let's see what are the occasions on which we do kite flying. On Independence Day, Makar Sankranti and Basant Panchami, kite flying competitions are held in our country. For instance, it is Makar Sankranti. Divya, Tanu, Saloni and Saurabh are very excited. In their colony, there is a kite flying competition. There are all other groups of children from the nearby society who are good at kite flying. Their names are Anuj, Sadhana, Adya and Ajay. Uncle Sakshan brought special kites and thread needed to fly the kites. All the people are at home. Kite flying started. There were shouts all around and the sky was full of colorful kites. Soon all the kites disappeared one by one and only Saurabh's kite was flying. He was declared as the winner and he was awarded a school bag kit and a trophy. All the people were very happy and went to their home happily. So here is something that I want all of you to do. Decide with your family. Sit with your family in the evening and with them decide what are the 4-5 recreational activities that all of you can do maybe once a month. All right. And remember, what did I tell you? That we are supposed to listen to everyone's suggestion and take a fair decision. Thank you so much and enjoy studying and also enjoy playing. Thank you.